Y.1564 is an industry standard service activation test for Ethernet and IP to measure key performance indicators, including throughput, both committed information rate and excess information rate, frame delay or latency, frame delay variation or jitter, and frame loss rate. VIAVI has enhanced the methodology into an ideal workflow for metro Ethernet service acceptance, especially those with multiple classes of service. Our implementation includes a J-Quick Check pretest, easy triple play emulation, committed burst size testing, and other enhancements to ensure network performance and reduce total test time. The simple three-step workflow is a standard feature for all Ethernet options on OneAdvisor 800 platforms. The workflow can be run with multiple streams and classes of service, or with a single stream and an abbreviated workflow. It can be run at layer 2 or at layer 3. One additional configuration screen allows IPv4 or IPv6 addressing to be configured. All modules with optical hardware can be licensed for 10 megabit to 25 gigabit Ethernet testing using SFP ports, and 100 gigabit testing using QSFP ports. 400 gig modules can also be optioned for 50, 200, and 400 gigabit testing. The user interface is the same at all rates from 1 megabit per second to 400 gigabits per second. The workflow will prompt you to configure a test, loop up the far end device, start traffic, measure key performance indicators, and save a pass-fail report. I will demonstrate a layer 2 multiple stream RFC 2544 test with a 1 gig optical transceiver in port 1 of my OneAdvisor 800. The transceiver is connected to an Ethernet switch, which is connected to a second switch with a VIAVI loopback device on one of its ports. The loopback device is another OneAdvisor, but it could be a VIAVI T-Bird 5800, MAP 2100, NSC 200 Network and Service Companion, an OAM maintenance endpoint, JMEP loopable SFP, Fusion Virtual Test Agent NID, or any other compatible loopback. I will now demonstrate the test application. I have powered up my OneAdvisor. From the home screen, I will tap Tests to display the test menu, tap Transport to show the transport test application, and tap the transport icon. I can now launch the test with a single tap on my pre-configured favorite tests list or from the Select Test menu. I will use the Select Test menu to select Ethernet, 1 gig optical, Y.1564 SAMComplete, layer 2 multiple streams on port 1. I now have options to edit my last test configuration, load a configuration from a previously saved profile, or start a new configuration with default settings. I'll go with the third option. The default settings can be viewed and customized in a series of configuration screens connected by Next and Back buttons. Although there are several screens, most settings can be left at defaults. The first screen shows summary settings for the test. The OneAdvisor Y.1564 workflow supports symmetric links terminated a loopback device. This next screen shows local port settings. I recommend leaving frame type at default for most use cases. The light blue link will display additional settings. If you're using a non-VIAVI loopback device, these settings allow you to use a unicast MAC address. If you're using a VIAVI loopback device and the default settings, the OneAdvisor will broadcast a loop-up message and learn the MAC address. The link is active, and I'm configured to auto-negotiate pause settings. This next screen lets you configure services. Set number of services to the number of VLANs, classes of service, or frame sizes that you wish to generate. I'll go with 4. Leave test mode at the default, traffic, unless your loopback device is a carrier Ethernet maintenance endpoint, supporting OAM loopback messages. Leave layer at L1 unless you want to exclude layer 1 overhead from the throughput results. Service names can be set to describe each service. For example, voice, video, priority data, and best effort. Under service properties, the configure triple play button lets you define the services as a specified number of voice calls or IP video channels. The light blue link lets you configure advanced settings for each service. I will leave destination MAC address at default for a VIAVI loopback device. Leave ether type at default and configure a range of frame sizes. In the next screen, encapsulation can be changed to VLAN or Q&Q if tagging is required. All services can use the same VLAN settings, or they can be different for each service. Next, the committed information rate and excess information rate can be entered for each service. If the individual services are not being policed at these rates, uncheck the policing checkbox. The sum of the committed information rates cannot exceed the line rate. L1 megabits per second means that load relating settings will include layer 1 overhead. When set to line rate, the ONA will still leave a small amount of bandwidth so that network elements can broadcast control plane messages such as spanning tree and link layer discovery protocol. If you want true 100% traffic, tap the blue advanced settings link and tap the checkbox. Burst testing can be enabled by tapping yes. One burst size can be entered for all services, or different burst sizes can be specified per stream. Pass-fail service acceptance thresholds can also be entered for all services or per stream. I'm going to enter values typical for cell backhaul. There are two stages to the Y.1564 test. The service configuration test is a ramp test that validates the configuration of each service individually. Service performance test validates the quality of the services when all services are transmitted concurrently at their committed information rates. Default durations result in a total test time of about 10 minutes. Durations can be increased or decreased according to your service level agreement or standard operating procedure. That's it for the configuration dialog. I can now optionally save these settings into a profile for future use. By default, both the service configuration test and service performance test will be run for all services. An RFC 2544 throughput measurement can optionally be added. I am now ready to run tests. JQuickCheck is a pretest. It will verify local connectivity and identify the type of loopback device. It will quickly identify common issues so that you don't waste time running a long test that fails. You can go straight to troubleshooting. If you need to recheck the configuration, the Go-To button lets you quickly navigate to different configuration screens. The Results button lets you view the underlying Layer 2 traffic test application, where you can view detailed real-time results while making real-time configuration changes to characterize any service issues. The Camera button will store a screenshot on the OneAdvisor hard drive. The Next button advances us to the Y1564 test screen, where I will run the test. As I estimated, the test will take about 10 minutes to complete, up to 5 minutes for service configuration, and 5 minutes for service performance. In the meantime, I can view test progress by tapping a magnifying glass. And when the test is complete, green check marks and red X's indicate whether the test passed or failed. The last phase of the workflow is report creation. I can enter header information, including customer name, tech ID, test location, work order number, and comments. I can also import a logo from the images folder. I can create a report in a variety of formats, including PDF. The concise report includes instrument information, overall test results, optical power levels, the test results, both tabular and graphs, followed by the test configuration. And that concludes the workflow.